The fragile peace in Yugoslavia is more fragile than ever. Truce talks between federal officials and the Republic of Slovenia broke down again today, and the president of Yugoslavia's largest republic is warning his people to be prepared for war. The latest from ABC's Mike Lee.
Yugoslav federal officials and Slovenian leaders were today face to face, but not eye to eye on the trigger issue, which threatens renewed fighting. The Slovenians refused to give up control over border crossings into Western Europe. The federal government offered up a compromise. Slovenia could run the borders on behalf of the Yugoslav government, but give up the money made from customs fees. No thanks, said the Slovenians today. That latest breakdown in talks has brought new warnings of doom. In the federal capital, Belgrade, Slobodan Milošević, leader of the Serbs, the nation's dominant ethnic group, said he no longer opposes the breakup of Yugoslavia into independent states, but the Serbs, backed by the army, said Milošević, will fight to keep control of Serbian enclaves within the breakaway republics like Croatia. The tension between Croatians and minority Serbs has become intense, with daily claims and counterclaims of murders. The Croatian government today predicted a major attack within the next few days by federal army units aiming to take control of Serbian communities. But Stepic Mesic, head of the Federal Presidential Council, himself a Croat, said that the army is back under political control and that it is still possible to negotiate a prolonged ceasefire. The parade of diplomats continues. The Soviets are visiting, but they have yet to show any clout in this crisis or the will to use it. A negotiating team from the European community arrives tonight to help monitor a ceasefire which many are counting on, but almost no one is betting on. Mike Lee, ABC News, Zagreb, Yugoslavia.